Tengo dos opciones.
Gaza siempre tenía un muy buen mar. Peces de pequeños, como un grano, así, lo sacan, porque no pueden pescar hasta 100 metros en el mar.
Me acuerdo de la primera vez que realmente conocí el mal del ser humano fue a los 4 años en Chile. En mi casa siempre escuchábamos mucha música, bailábamos con mi madre, con mi padre y estábamos bailando o escuchando música, me acuerdo, y de repente se interrumpe la radio por una voz diabólica, masculina de un hombre que gritaba.
Evacúe la moneda, va a ser más fácil asaltarla.
Una vez bombardeado, asaltado con el buen y con la infantería. Hay que decirle a él.
Conforme.
Las cámaras quedarán en receso hasta nueva hora.
En mi familia siempre estaba vigente, digamos, la memoria de lo que pasó en Chile, de mi padre.
Me voy a desmayar de frío.
Yo vivo en Suecia desde 1985 y vine como refugiada política de Chile con mi madre y mi hermana. Mi mamá siempre me hablaba de la opresión contra el pueblo palestino y de la lucha que ellos llevaban para su liberación.
Cuando yo veo estas imágenes, yo tendría aproximadamente 11 años. Lo grave de este asunto es que no fue una situación aislada de unos soldados que se volvieron locos, sino que se ordenó a los soldados que rompieran los brazos de todos los niños que pudieran para quebrar la resistencia de los palestinos. Quebrar la resistencia de los palestinos era quebrar los brazos de los niños palestinos. Lo que yo creo que jamás imaginaría cuando tenía 11 años es que casi 20 años después yo estaría con una cámara filmando imágenes similares y a tratar de interesarme, sobre todo por las realidades más silenciadas.
What I see on in the Western media is an attempt
to be balanced in most cases. Sometimes it seems like they're completely one-sided, but much of the time they're trying to be neutral. But you know, this conflict isn't neutral. When you look at the number of people, for example, that are killed on both sides, it's not a fair fight and it's not a neutral story. But the BBC, for example, they'll show 10 Palestinians are killed in Gaza, and then they'll show, to balance it, a rocket attack. They'll give the same amount of time to a rocket attack. A rocket falls somewhere on the border. It doesn't kill anybody, it doesn't injure anybody, but the people are upset. So for them, this is balance.
Abans de l'operació Plom Fos no tinc imatges de Palestina. Era com tantes altres persones que els bombardejaven amb mil notícies diferents, amb poca informació de cada cosa, i que allò em passava d'una manera desapercebuda. No tinc imatges de Palestina. Les úniques que recordo, i per lo impactants que van ser l'operació Plom Fos.
If I want to go from my city to Qalqilya, to Tulkarem, or to Nablus, to my university, the journey usually will take half an hour. It will take me 3-4 hours. I have to go through at least 17 to 25 checkpoints. Every time they will search you, humiliate you, make you feel that big. I've seen in front of my eyes, you know, farmers being asked to eat grass like donkeys with the donkeys as a permission to cross the checkpoint. I've saw in my eyes a small child being asked to slap his daddy as a permission to cross the checkpoint.
Nadia, stand,
stand. My mother was pregnant and she lost my brother on a checkpoint going to give birth in a hospital. All of this you see on a daily basis and it's make you feel so angry, hopeless. So we start avoiding these checkpoints and walk by the mountain. So we prefer to walk 5 hours rather than go through this humiliation.
Both sides are human beings. Both sides have families. Both sides have mothers and sisters and brothers and fathers. But on television, you only see the emotional side of the Israeli families.
And it's just very insulting when you don't have the chance to say what you actually feel, what is your side of the story, and what is it that going inside your heart.
My name is Dror Feile. I am 59 years old. I'm born in Israel in 1951. I moved to Sweden when I was 22 years old, after my military service of 3 years in the parachutists. And since 1983, when I finished the music academy, I've been working as a musician, as a composer, as an artist, and I am all the years also a political activist. I am a good soldier, but I don't accept anything that is against the law. We have a law in the army too, and you will know. If you do something against the law, I will inform. I will directly. Some of the officers, they kick me out, send me somewhere else. Some of them accept me.
Sorry, Erkas, Blikas! Blikas!
In 1970, I was 19, I was sent to Gaza, and I refused. I said, no, I don't go, because I don't go as a soldier in populated with civilians, because I will be war criminal sooner or later. I am soldier. A soldier is to fight with other soldiers. It's bad enough. I am not trained to deal with citizens, with civilians, so I don't do it. I say what happened between Israel and the people of Gaza is not a war, it's an assault, it's an attack. I know that you usually we use the word war because it sounds bigger, but it's giving also a wrong connotation of what is to do. My father was born in 1921 in Germany, and he was a left-wing Jew, and Hitler came to power in 1933. He lived under Hitler regime until 38. 38, as a 17 years old boy, he left Germany to Palestine because it was the only place he could get a certificate to go to. He was never a Zionist, but he saved his life by moving.
Out of Palestine comes the camera story of the Exodus, the Jewish immigrant ship that highlights new violence in the Holy Land. With a cargo of 4,500 refugees, the Exodus is the largest ship ever to attempt to run the watchful British naval blockade.
I think it's natural. I think the experience of being persecuted make you feel solidarity with other people who's persecuted. You understand that to be persecuted many times is not because that you done something wrong. Sometimes it's because prejudice, sometimes because the people in power don't want you to express yourself or to have your rights. So I think in a way it's very natural to do so.
Estuve hablando con algunos amigos, me dicen que, pero no vas a cambiar nada, eres solo una persona y tienes 29 años y este problema es desde antes de que naciste, pues no vas a cambiar nada. Eres tonta porque te vas a arriesgar tu vida por una causa que nadie no ha podido hacer nada, pues ¿por qué te vas? Quiero ir. Porque no puedo seguir solo sentando y viendo la televisión y escribir. Quería quizás sentir lo que vive la gente ahí, ver lo que pasa ahí de verdad y hablar con la gente que vive ahí, saber qué piensan, qué viven, qué piensan de nosotros también.
No paras, ¿no? Nos encontramos en el Mavi Marmara, ese barco que nos llevará a Gaza. En los próximos 3 días zarpamos, aunque hoy es el día que el barco en sí se mueve hasta un puerto del sur de Turquía, donde se cargará de más material y donde la mayoría de internacionales subiremos pues, en Antalya. Nosotros llegaremos... ¿Vale?
Va ser una decisió presa molt en calent. És a dir, quan decidim anar allà, és a dir, quan diem sí, venim, no hi havia valoracions de riscos, de qui hi havia, qui deixava d'haver-hi tot plegat. Era, anem allà, hem fet la marxa per la llibertat de Gaza, no hem aconseguit entrar, ens vam sentir supermaltractats per les autoritats egípcies, a més, ho vam viure en pròpia pell, no? El no deixar-te entrar en un lloc i, bueno, no sé, doncs ara hi entrem per mar, no?
Si queria ir, tenia que arreglar todas mis cosas y viajar al día siguiente. Así que bueno, tomé rápidamente la decisión de que a ver, conseguiré un pasaje, puedo dejar las cosas que tengo pendiente acá. Sí, lo hago.
Mi madre la cosa que me dijo es que puedes ir, pero tengo una condición. Llévame arena de Gaza, de Palestina. Algo me va a pasar, es un peligro, es un riesgo, pero aún acepto que yo puedo ir porque quiere también sentir que ella también está haciendo algo, quizás a través de mí, que ella no ha podido hacerlo, pero yo lo puedo hacerlo y por ella eso significa algo, significa que ella está haciendo algo por los palestinos.
Her şeyden önce anneydim, benim de iki evladım vardı ve Gazze'de olanları, yaşananları yakından takip ediyorduk. Ve bir Müslüman olarak da şu inanışa göre yetiştiriliyorsunuz. Peygamber Efendimizin bir hadis-i şerifi var. Bir yerde bir zulüm varsa onu elinle düzelt. Onu elinle düzeltemiyorsan onu dilinle düzelt. Dilinle düzeltemiyorsan en son kalben buğz et. Bu da imanın en hafifidir. Yani benim suçum neydi diyordu. O yüzden bizim kendi evlatlarımız neyse oradakiler de bizim için bu olmalı.
We have one goal. Break the illegal siege of Gaza and send the ship to Gaza. The ship will have several messages. One message is the solidarity, we send things. The second message is the political, we don't accept the siege. And the third message is humanity. We want to defend our humanity and their humanity.
Break the siege or destroy the siege or end the siege or any of these things. But we know that we are breaking our own siege first, and that what take us there. And the idea make those who feel lonely and isolated feel so cherished and feel that there is basically somebody there that I love and he's coming and he cares about me. Because you know that feeling of loneliness what create desperate situations and create frustration and make people surrender.
La gente necesita vivir. En Gaza hay 1.5 million de personas. No son 10.000 ni 20.000, no es un pueblo pequeño, hay 1.5 million de personas.
Estamos hablando también de las órdenes que tendrían las autoridades israelíes de detener esa embarcación. Incluso también tenemos imágenes de los centros en donde serían alojadas estas personas. Hasta el momento, ¿hubo alguna manifestación de agresión por parte de estas tropas israelíes?
No, nada, el mar Mediterráneo se mantiene en calma. Te puedo informar también que tanto los activistas como la organización se encuentran con el ánimo excelente, hay un ánimo de seguir adelante y de resistir.
Se encuentran aproximadamente 750 pasajeros en estos 9 barcos, de más de 50 nacionalidades diferentes, y están cargando aproximadamente unas 10.000 toneladas de ayuda humanitaria, consistente en material médico, material sanitario, educativo y también, y es muy de destacar, también se lleva cemento y acero para la reconstrucción de las casas bombardeadas durante la guerra.
The people in Gaza knows that we can see. The people in Gaza knows that all the world can see through television. What will they think about us? It's not only I do it for the Palestinians. I do it also for myself to keep my own humanity. What kind of human being will I be when I can see that people are being slaughtered and I don't do anything? What will the people in Gaza think about us if we don't do anything?
Normalin dışında bir şeyler yapmanız lazım. Biz de onu zaten yapmaya çalışıyoruz. Ha, yani dünyanın işte 30 küsür farklı ülkesinden birçok insan hakları aktivistinin, birçok farklı inanca sahip insanın kalkıp birkaç gemiye doluşup Gazze'ye gitmesi.
Şeyden mi? Bir şey olmayacak. İşte ben basın odasındayım. Çok fazla bir şey yapamazlar çünkü biz uluslararası sularda hareket edeceğiz. Dolayısıyla onların bize müdahale etme hakları yok. Yapamazlar böyle bir şeyi. İşte onlar gitmeden önce belli bir şey çizmişlerdi. O da şey demişti, bu gemide ben gideyim, çocukların yanında sen kal. Bir sonraki gemide sen gidersin, çocukların yanında da ben kalırım demişti. Daha önce işte birkaç defa gitmişti. Biz engel olmaya çalışmıştık. Gitmesini biraz istemiyordum ben. Çünkü sırtımı dayadığım tek insan, çok sevdiğim bir insan. Onu kaybetmek istemiyorum. ve Almanya'da takir bölgeye gemi gittikten sonra
la toute première chose, moi, qui m'a frappée, c'est toute l'atmosphère, beaucoup d'énergie positive, beaucoup de gens engagés. Pourtant, il y avait des gens qui venaient de différents pays. Il y avait plus de 40 nationalités, des gens de confessions différentes.
Quand nous avons décidé de estar en esta flota, hemos dejado todas las otras cosas, las identidades, las nacionalidades, las ideas, las religiones. Atrás de nosotros era que somos seres humanos que vamos a embarcar para ayudar a otros seres humanos que necesitan ayuda y que viven en la injusticia. Y vamos a apoyarlos.
No íbamos solamente a romper con el bloqueo de Gaza. Se sentía, era como una cosa tan simbólica también de quebrar tanta censura, tanta hipocresía, íbamos a quebrar el olvido de lo que es justo, que es tan simple.
Alors, j'ai pas du tout senti une pression, quelle qu'elle soit, ou un contrôle, bien au contraire. On faisait partie, en fait, moi je le vois vraiment comme une grande famille. Et donc chacun avait une certaine responsabilité vis-à-vis de l'autre sur ce bateau, parce que nous étions dans un même état d'esprit, un esprit de solidarité.
És a dir, hi havia una bandera palestina, hi havia un missatge que algú volia donar, hi havia algú llegint el Corà, altres cantant. Ah, és que era... És a dir, era l'Arca de Noé. Gemideki kameralar vasıtasıyla oradaki insanlardan haberdar olabiliyorduk. Ben eşimi de kameralarda arada bir görüyordum. Her şey yolundaydı, her şey güzeldi.
My nature is not to sit down and chill back and relax and talk. No, I just have to kind of, if I see something going wrong, I'll fix it. If there's an interesting conversation, I'll just be part of that conversation. If there's like a music, I'll be part of that music. If there's singing, I'll be part of the singing. So I start singing in Turkish and Spanish and Arabic and whatever. Like, I just crazy, amazing.
What is the song about?
It's about my name. And my address, and my home in Palestine.
David, ya para finalizar este valioso contacto telefónico contigo, ¿cuál es el espíritu que mantienen los tripulantes que están a bordo de esta flotilla Libertad?
Se podría expresar que el ambiente aquí es electrizante. Hay una gran tensión, pero sobre todo una gran emoción y una gran determinación. Piden la reconstrucción después de la guerra de hospitales, escuelas, universidades y viviendas en la franja bloqueada de Gaza. Son una serie de ayudas que el gobierno israelí, que el Estado israelí está bloqueando.
We expected that the Western media would try and play this down. The BBC weren't interested, the American media weren't really interested. I heard that the BBC's phone lines were jammed at one point because there were so many people calling up saying, look, you aren't covering the news. There are British people on this ship. You're not covering it. People start to wonder, is there some sort of agenda here? Because if you were neutral, you would cover this. You don't have to be pro-Gaza, you don't have to be pro-activist, but you'd cover it at least. You would talk about it, you'd do a live broadcast, maybe with the Israeli defense minister, and maybe with somebody from the ship to balance it, but you would cover it. But the BBC, I don't know, they didn't cover it.
Aquesta és la televisió que ens donen i ens matxaquen dia a dia als països occidentals. per això no vull estar treballant en una televisió d'aquí, perquè per això no vull estar en un mitjà que expliqui el que jo no vull explicar. Jo vull explicar el que allà vaig viure, que no vaig viure només jo, que viu molta gent i que qualsevol palestí podria explicar això cada dia de la seva vida des de més de 60 anys. No?
Uno trataba de convencerse que no, que íbamos a llegar a Gaza. Yo por lo menos trataba de ver como señales. Luna llena, no, significa que vamos a llegar a Gaza. El mar está muy calmo, vamos a llegar a Gaza.
We're making history here, all of us together. The hundreds of us on our boats. And behind the hundreds of us on our boats are millions of people worldwide watching us and they're praying for our success.
אנחנו חיילי צה"ל, פועלים על פי רוח צה"ל ופועלים על פי ערכי צה"ל ואנחנו נפעל במקצועיות ובנחישות. אין לנו שום כוונה לפגוע באף אחד מהאנשים האלה. וביחד עם זאת יש לנו משימה מאוד מאוד ברורה לבצע. אנחנו נמנע מהם להיכנס לרצועה. שיהיה בהצלחה.
L'exèrcit israelià. Jo recordo haver baixat és a dir, on dormien les dones, que elles ja es començaven a activar, es posaven els xalecos salvavides, i jo anava sense, perquè no veia l'amenaça imminent, no? I ja, però què fas? Posa't el xaleco.
Là, par contre, on était dans l'attente. Qu'est-ce qui va se passer?
Three Israeli warships were spotted on the radar. And tension went up. And the journalists all went, okay, now we've got something happening. Now this is how it begins.
Mavi Marmara, you are approaching an area of hostilities, which is under a naval blockade. The Gaza area, coastal region, and Gaza harbor are closed to all maritime traffic.
They are going to orders. One is behind the Daphne, and there are three coming this way, and there's one farther away, okay? They are just coming closer and closer.
This is a message to the world. We are in international waters. We're 80 miles off the coast of Gaza, yet Israeli warships are threatening us. There are two that we are aware of on the radar. They are cutting the Turksat satellite system on and off to try and prevent the world knowing what Israel is preparing to do. This is against international law. We are calling on the world to take action to stop Israel from violating international law and stop threatening us. Stop cutting the satellite. Let the world know what is happening.
وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا والله عزيز حكيم الله أكبر.
Tres fragatas israelíes nos están amenazando. Allá al fondo tenemos una de ellas que podemos ver desde aquí. El pánico que podría cundir entre las cientos de personas que hay aquí ante un ataque de un ejército en un barco de estas características podría ser fatal. Hemos hecho un llamamiento por las redes sociales y por internet a que la ciudadanía despierta a sus políticos y que los pongan activo y que pasen la noche con nosotros, atentos a lo que pudiera pasar.
Son kez bana telefon açtı. Orada hakkınızı helal edin dedi. Ben o zaman hani yani bu normal bir konuşma değil. Onu anladım. Bununla ne demek istiyordu. Orada da çocuklara iyi bak ve hakkını helal et diye yazmıştı.
Okay, we're gonna start. We're gonna start in 10 seconds. Everybody was getting a bit anxious. We're here still in the Mediterranean Sea. We've been making our way towards the Gaza Strip in international waters.
Durante la transmisión directa, cuando el periodista estaba transmitiendo lo que está pasando, a su lado habían pasajeros de todos los países para mostrar al mundo que somos solo gentes normales. Que no tenemos ninguna armas, estamos aquí para ayudar a los palestinos.
I'm not sure whether this is an attempt to scare the convoy volunteers or whether this is a serious threat at this stage, but as you can probably see around me, people have put on their life jackets just in case, because we don't really know what the Israelis are going to do. They've made very serious threats. They've said this convoy
los israelíes estaban también intentando de cortar el señal. Pues será como cada periodista, cada vez que el señal regresa, intenta solo de enviar un mensaje rápido, hablar sobre el ambiente que está en el barco y para dejar el lugar a otro periodista.
Seconds I was there in shock, but then my brain kind of switched mode into my job. Okay, now they're here, let's grab the camera. I ran back downstairs, grabbed the camera, and I started filming.
L'hélicoptère était là, j'entends des coups et l'impact des balles sur le bateau. Toujours en train de filmer, je me dis mais qu'est-ce qui se passe là? Ils sont pas en train de nous tirer dessus? C'est pas possible.
The helicopter tried to descend
Israeli commandos on board. If you can see around us, there are Israeli naval ships.
Sonra ateş durdu. Helikopterlerden halatlar sarkıtıldı. Halatlardan askerler inmeye başladığında arkadaşlarımız halatlara yapıştılar. Askerler yere düştü.
I'm not going to deny that we used every single means to resist them taking over the ship. I was filming and then suddenly something fell on top of my head. And that was later on I realized it's a soldier. He's looking at me and then he's grabbing his Uzi. He starts shooting. So I could see the vibration of the Uzi. Just let go, don't shoot, just let go.
You can hear behind me, that is the sound of some sort of artillery being fired.
We have had several injuries here. One is critical, he has been injured in the head. We think he may die if he does not receive medical treatment immediately. Another person being taken past behind, in front of me right now has been seriously injured. We have Navy ships on either side and helicopters overhead. We are being attacked from every single side.
We need the doctor? The doctor available? Very urgent, very urgently.
Doctor, doctor, we need you urgently.
Enfin,
moi j'étais en bas et j'entendais des cris, des gens qui couraient. Et donc je me dis, ce qui est en train de se passer au-dessus, ça doit être horrible. Et effectivement, les blessés arrivaient par dizaines, vraiment par dizaines.
Abi aşağı alalım ya.
Alacak.
Sonra o askerleri aşağıya verilmek üzere, İsrail askerleri, zaten silahları alınmış ve silahları denize atılmıştı. O silahlar arkadaşlarımız tarafından kullanılabilirdi de, fakat kimse öyle bir şey düşünmedi. O etkisiz hale getirilen İsrail askerlerini aşağıya vermek üzere bize arkadaşlarımız aşağı inin dediler. Ben öyle aşağıya indim. Bize verdiler o askerleri. Üçünü biliyorsunuz, zaten aldık üç askeri. Aşağıya doktorlara indirdi arkadaşlarımız ve doktorlar onları tedavi ettiler.
Evet, iner.
The IHH took that soldier, they took him inside for his own safety, because you know they're throwing grenades onto the ship, they're killing people on the ship, so a lot of people are going to try and, you know, in their anger they might do something to the soldier, so they took him inside for his own safety.
Com havien de ser aquestes persones? És a dir, nosaltres, els nostres companys, per actuar d'aquesta manera, no? Per desarmar-los i no utilitzar les armes en contra dels altres. Bueno, pues és que era un barc humanitari. És que el que anàvem a fer era trencar un bloqueig d'una manera legal.
دنا على بني إسرائيل أنه من قتل نفسه نفسا بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا ولقد جاء
şey dedi hatta bugün olmaz dedi rüyamda bana çünkü üst üste görüyordum hatta şey zannetmiştim o gün acaba birinin ihtiyacı vardı onun rüyasına mı gitti gibisinden işte gazete hazırlamam gerekirdi bir gazeteci olarak yardım ederdi gazetenin nasıl hazırlanması gerektiğini veya işte bir haberin nasıl yazılacağını bana anlatırdı
evin neşe kaynağıydı yani şu an ev onsuz çok sessiz Çocukları çok severdi. Onları mutlu etmekten çok hoşlanırdı.
Hani neler yapabiliriz diye düşünüyorduk genellikle.
Nunca se fue a un lugar sin su cámara de fotografía.
Cevdet eğilmiş dizlerinin üzerinde üst kattaki askerin 1,5 metre üstündedir. Çok mesafe yok. Askerin fotoğrafını çekmeye çalışıyordu. Çok mermi atıldığı için hangi mermi Cevdet'e atıldı, hangisi bize atılıyor fark etmiyorum. Sadece düştüğünü fark ettim. Döndüğümde Cevdet vurulmuştu.
El ataque de los comandos se inició aproximadamente a las 4:30 de la madrugada y terminaría aproximadamente una hora después. En menos de una hora, los comandos pudieran asesinar a 9 personas y herir gravemente con armas de fuego a 53 personas. Las cifras hablan por sí mismas. Las cifras de muertos y heridos solo están en un bando.
What do you think soldier is trained to? Soldier is trained to kill. He's not trained to stop demonstration. He is not trained to deal with civilians, with civil disobedience. He is especially commando troop. They are trained. And they did their job. They killed.
I participated in two autopsies in Mavi Marmara incident, and one of them is Cevdet Kılıçlar.
Cause of death of Cevdet Kılıçlar is the firearm injury to his head.
I've seen dead bodies. I filmed dead bodies. But this was different because these people I had known as a person. And now they were lying before me, dead. Not dead because they'd done something wrong. Not dead because they'd tried to harm anybody else, but dead because they tried to help somebody else.
The distant shot means that on short-barreled guns, 35 or 45 centimeters. For long-barreled guns, it's over 1 meter.
Ellos tenían la fuerza, tenían las armas, pero ellos nos temían más a nosotros, que éramos civiles. O sea, ellos venían con el miedo.
What we have learned from Second World War is that you cannot obey orders, because many of the German soldiers say, oh, there was a commander, he told us to do that, and he couldn't do that, and we did. So it's not our fault, it's the commander's fault. And then commander said there was another commander, and in the end, you end in the top, and the top is not there, so nobody is guilty. Nobody is being able to put the responsibility on. And the Israeli army, because of this experience, have a law that you have to refuse if it's illegal.
I had 2 tapes, one I gave to a lady to hide and one I hid on myself. When they found it, I said, look, I'm a journalist, here's my press card, will I get my tape back? And I asked that question 3 times. The 3rd time, I got punched in the back of the head and thrown down some stairs. That was the response when you said, I'm a journalist, can I keep my footage? There was no way in hell you were going to keep your footage.
For me, it was the largest, the hugest attack against free press I know, because they put all journalists to prison, they took all the equipment, and maybe more important, they have all the tapes, beside of a few tapes we could hide.
És a dir, privar de la llibertat de premsa era el primer objectiu que tenia Israel en la flotilla de la llibertat. Perquè si la veritat no sortia a la llum, ells podrien donar el missatge a nivell periodístic que els interessava.
Only if you want to hide something, and this is the only explanation why they interrupted all the connections, and they also intercepted all the tapes and all the recordings we did.
És a dir, el més fort de tot plegat per mi va ser veure per la televisió imatges que no sé si exactament eren en directe, però si no eren de moments abans, emeses en directe per una televisió turca, no?
Onların bunu yapmasına zaten izin verdik. Yani bizi engelleyebileceklerini düşünmelerini istemiştik zaten. Karar el-i'tirad. İ'tirad es-sufur ve muhacemetiha kana kararan muvakkaan. Ancak yayın devam edince, insanlar yaşananları görünce bunu yapamadılar. Ve ben inanıyorum ki çok sayıda insanın hayatını kurtardı orayı.
En aquell moment va ser com dir, bueno, és que això ja ho sap el món.
The results of last night's events are tragic and unfortunate, and Israel deeply regrets any loss of innocent lives. But it cannot compromise its security. Nobody would. We can also not ignore the most basic necessity of an obligation of Israel to safeguard its security by appropriate measures when threatened.
Terrorismo adelantado por los grandes países, el terrorismo de Estado.
Todos los movimientos solidarios, viva la lucha del pueblo palestino.
Terrorista, Israel, terrorista, terrorista.
Luchamos por el derecho del pueblo palestino a existir. Queremos ratificar el repudio del gobierno bolivariano por esta masacre contra un grupo de hombres y mujeres que solamente llevaban un alivio al pueblo palestino.
According to our Abrahamic tradition and my own belief, killing one human being is killing humanity as a whole. Yesterday, humanity drowned in the international waters of the Mediterranean. This unacceptable action was perpetrated by those who in the past had taken advantage of ships carrying refugees and those escaping one of the worst tragedies of the last century. They should be more aware than most of the importance of humanitarian assistance, of the dangers and inhumanity of ghettos as the one we currently witness in occupied Gaza.
La Armada Británica tenía un bloqueo naval sobre Palestina y el éxodo en 1947 con miles de refugiados que huyendo de la persecución, del nazismo, se dirigió hacia Palestina cuando se acerca a las costas de Palestina y en aguas internacionales los comandos británicos asaltan el barco y los judíos se defienden. En esa batalla campal sucede lo mismo que en el Mar y Mármara. Estos comandos no se les ha enseñado su propia historia. La historia de cuando ellos eran los débiles. La historia de cuando ellos eran los refugiados. De cuando los judíos lanzaban flotillas de la libertad con la misma dirección hacia Palestina. No aprendió la lección del Holocausto como un nunca más hacia toda la humanidad, no solo como un nunca más hacia ellos.
The flotilla consists of citizens of 32 countries, representing many faiths, Christianity, Islam, Judaism, and people from all creeds and backgrounds.
Dolayısıyla bizim zaten tarihimizde Yahudiler Avrupa'dan gemilerle denize bırakıldıklarında bize sığınmışlardı ve bizim topraklarımızda 500 yıldır çok rahatlıkla yaşayabildiler. Bizim Yahudilerle hiçbir alıp veremediğimiz yok, onlara karşı bizzat bir düşmanlığımız yok. Bizim problemimiz Siyonist rejimle ve onun yapmış olduğu, orada masum halka uygulamış olduğu şiddet ve zulümle bizim problemimiz.
Con la llegada del nazismo a Europa y Alemania, Albert Einstein se comunica con las autoridades turcas y le solicita protección para los científicos judíos alemanes. Y fieles a su tradición, acogen y refugian a estos judíos que tanto aportarían a la sociedad turca. Dice Einstein que hay una fuerza que es más poderosa que el vapor, que la energía eléctrica, que la energía atómica, y es la voluntad. La fe.
We're talking suddenly to the soldiers, trying to kind of explain the situation of the injured people, and when I saw their crude and ugly way that they treated the injured, I've just lost it. I became very aggressive. And you know, they put me on the ground, they forced me on the ground with a plastic thing on my head, suffocated me. I fell two times, I wanted to die. When I was taken outside, and you know, they have a lot of computers that they destroyed, lots of mobile phones, like a mountain of everything. And when we got to the shore, all these mobile phones picked up signal. So I'm sitting on top of these mobile phones and I'm just hearing all these tunes and all this vibration. It's like an orchestra. Thousands of people calling their loved ones, their family members. And then I've heard my mobile phone. I've heard my mobile phone out of all these phone calls. And I was sitting there and I had a tear in my eyes. I don't know why, but I had this kind of beautiful song on my mobile phone, my ringtone, which say, منصوب القامة يمشي مرتفع الهامة يمشي منصوب القامة يمشي مرتفع القامة يمشي في كفي قصفة زيتون وعلى كتفي نعشي أنا أمشي وأنا أمشي وأنا أمشي وأنا وأنا وأنا أمشي لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا لا So I was suddenly like they're beating me and they don't really understand the meaning of that words, the meaning of that song. And out of this old craziness rings for these mobile phones, I'm hearing this song, which made me stronger than the fucking Israeli army, make me stronger than the whole almighty Israeli army. And I felt with that spirit, I'm okay.
Eline düşüyorsunuz. Bu yüzden şöyle düşünüyordum. Yani biz burada en az bir ay, iki ay kalırız. Belki 5-6 ay kalırız.
At a certain moment it was the question whether to sign a paper that we entered illegally Israel, which was nonsense because I was obliged by the soldiers to enter Israel. I never intended to go to Israel and just to leave immediately and to go home. And I said, why should I sign this immediately and leave all other passengers in prison, you know? Only because I have a special role as a journalist or whatever. And I thought, no, as a journalist, I have also to see what is happening in prison. So I decided to stay there as all the others stayed there too.
Si vous ne collaborez pas, vous irez en prison. Et moi, je lui réponds, ah bah ok, bah j'irai en prison.
One main question was when to leave. Maybe every prisoner is thinking about, and we had no idea. I couldn't call my family. I couldn't call a lawyer. There was no permission to do any phone call at all during these days.
La plus difficile pour moi, c'était de me dire que ma famille, qui était restée en Belgique, doit se demander, parce qu'ils ont certainement eu l'info, comme qu'on a été attaqué, et peut-être qu'ils pensent que je suis morte.
Üç gün boyunca uyku yok. Tabii ki sürekli İHA'dayız, konsolosluğun önündeyiz ve daha nereye kadar götürebilecek bunu düşünmeye başladık ama bize bu yaşadığımız her şey şunu da gösteriyordu. Demek ki Gazze'deki insanlar her gün bu işkenceyi, her gün bu sıkıntıyı ve korkuyu yaşıyordu o çocuklar. Her gün babalarını kaybetme korkusuyla yüzleşiyordu. Kadınlar her gün eşleri eve geri gelmeyecek korkusuyla yüzleşiyorlardı. O korkuyu bir nebze olsun çok yakından onların hislerini biz de duyma imkanı oldu. İmkanı oldu bizim için.
Hürriye, hürriye, nasıl hürriye? Kutsi barak yaptile, namazlar
muhali. Bir dakika, taraf cevva. Özellikle Türkiye Devleti'nin, Türkiye Cumhuriyeti Cumhurbaşkanı'nın, Dışişleri Bakanı'nın, Başbakan'ın müdahaleleri olmasaydı, Birleşmiş Milletler Güvenlik Konseyi'nin hemen toplanması ve ardından gerekli işte açıklamaların yapılması sağlanmasaydı, öyle tahmin ediyorum ki İsrail'in niyeti bizi, tamamımızı mümkünse, tamamımızı olmasa bile belli bir kısmımızı uzunca bir süre orada tutmaya niyeti vardı İsrail.
Je me souviendrai toujours de cette image. La porte de l'avion qui s'ouvre. Au moment où je sors, j'avais des milliers de gens en face de moi. Je me suis dit, oh my God, what happened? Enfin, à un moment donné de l'histoire, et j'espère que ce n'est que le début, c'est le commencement, on a pu attirer l'attention du monde entier sur la condition des Palestiniens. Et sur la situation du conflit.
Salam, salam. Oh.
Tabii biz indiğimizde Türkiye'ye gece saat 3.30 civarıydı. Bu yüzden çocukları uyutmuşlardı. Çocukları ben sabah görebildim, o gece göremedim. Sabah kahraman görünce onların gözünde tabii çocuklar kahraman bir baba. Çünkü bu arkadaşları özellikle ve çevreden işte İsrail askerlerini aldılar, denize attılar falan gibi gerçek olmayan ama çocukların hoşuna gidebilecek şeyler söylenmiş. Çünkü çocukların gözünde asker eli silahlı, siz silahlı değilsiniz. Nasıl askerlere karşı direnebiliyorsunuz? Özellikle büyük oğlum hala da bunu sorar. Yani nasıl direndiniz, nasıl şey yaptınız? Tabii çocuklar o yüzden sabah uyanır uyanmaz kucağımıza attılar ve güzel, hoş bir görüntüydü.
I think the spirit of friendship and comradeship that we have developed through this work, it will not be broken as long as we live. Suddenly, after our trip, we were looking on a new world. Suddenly, everyone was discussing the boats. They were discussing the siege. They were discussing the Israeli occupation. We have succeeded to change the agenda, and this, I think, is the most important.
Creo que la flotilla también ha representado un poder, digamos, cívico que nos ha sorprendido a todos, digamos. Ya no somos más una voz que pide. Somos una voz también que hace, que actúa.
Unfortunately, people have to pay with their lives. And I say all the time, for me, they are my martyrs too. They're not martyrs only of the Turkish. I'm not religious, but they are my martyrs. They died for something that is as important for me as for them.
La voz mundial se levantó, se opuso a lo que pasó con la Flotilla de la Libertad y eso supuso una gran presión, tanto a Israel como a Egipto, como a América, como a todos los que apoyan los hechos que hace Israel. Fue una presión que al final dio su fruto, que es abrir el paso fronterizo de Rafah y poder entrar algunas personas que no habían podido ver a su familia en muchísimos años.
Egipto dijo que va a abrir la frontera de Rafah sin condiciones para todas las ayudas humanitarias. Pero era como, wow, la frontera de Rafah ya está abierta. Pues imagínate qué alegría esto va a aportar a los palestinos. Al menos pueden salir, pueden sentir esta libertad de salir y entrar desde Egipto a Gaza.
Cuando he oído que la frontera de Rafah está abierta y se puede pasar, yo he ido para ver mi familia, para ver cómo están.
Me recibieron muy, muy bien y muchas celebraciones.
They must feel that they are loved, they are unique, they are special, and there is actually a very interesting phenomenon that is coming out of this disparate, unjust, and at the same time, oppressed situation. So it's not all negative, it's positive, because you are, guys, you're the generator of humanity. Thank you for making us feel together. Thank you for unifying us. Thank you for making us make new friends. Thank you for making people from Venezuela coming all the way to London to meet with other people. Thank you for taking us on a beautiful journey. Thank you for making us feel human. Thank you for making us proud to speak to our kids in the future and say we were part of this beautiful, human, humanitarian mission.
Ara sí, com he dit al principi, estava buscant què fer a la meva vida, quin era el meu lloc. Jo ara sé quin és el meu lloc. Jo tornaré a pujar en un vaixell per entrar a Gaza, perquè ara ja no només ho faig pel que ho feia abans, ara ja ho faig pel respecte que els hi tinc als meus companys de viatge caiguts en l'atac al Mavi Màrmara i ho faig per tot el que m'ha tocat viure, és a dir, ara ja ho estic fent en primera persona, és a dir, ja formo part del total, no?, del que és
Palestina y del que se sent como tal, ¿no?
Mucha gente piensa que uno cuando trabaja por Palestina está en contra a Israel. Uno está en contra de la ocupación de Palestina. O sea, la paz para, en este conflicto no solamente va a ser una paz para Palestina, también va a ser una paz para el pueblo israelí.
Casi un año después de la flotilla, Ken O'Keefe, uno de los activistas, consiguió entrar en Gaza.
We're just pulling up. First morning in the playground, Samouni family, and well, it looks like it's going down quite swimmingly, I think.
Right here is where we can build a gathering place, and hopefully a place for teachers and psychologists to come to actually help out these children.
Emotionally, every single person on that ship is a tree. You kill it from the top, go deeper in the ground, with more roots to come even stronger. Because death and guns and warships is not the language that we are using in 2010, certainly not 2011, and not anymore. And it's not about the will of the strength, it's about the strength of the will.